Hello everyone, welcome back to a new YouTube cast. Today we're going to be having a look at a game played between the top right spawning as the Red Circle Ragnarok and bottom left as the blue Protoss player. Mr. Creator opened up with a hatch block, then scouted if the hatch indeed was there. And I was like, okay, it's there, that's all good. Let's hop into the main base to try and harass a little bit of that drone line. Now, of course, it doesn't do a lot. I keep telling people, I always see people do this, and trust me, if you have the APM for it, you should do it, because every little bit matters at the end of the day, but it's gonna maximum cost a Zerg 15 to 20, 25 minerals at max. But it is annoying because it might delay their speed a bit. The early game of the Zerg is pretty tight. And if you can delay it just a little bit, that's of course very helpful. Now, we're seeing a standard Nexus into core here. So there's one gate expand coming out of Creator. We'll go into second cast, second pylon. And as he's doing a natural block, I wouldn't be completely surprised to see Twilight Council go down, even though a lot of the natural blocks nowadays also go into Stargate. Before, it almost was a telltale sign that there was going to be some Glaive Adept action happening, but nowadays I feel like it really can be anything. If you block that natural, Tosses were like, well, why don't we just build oracles? And then Zerg was like, well, that's annoying. Now I need to prepare for many things. Okay, we see warp gate straight away. Still doesn't indicate anything. Actually cancels the warp gate. So it was a warp gate fake. Ragnarok probably did realize that. Yeah, I'm just checking his cam real fast. He moves a lot. I think, yeah, he definitely saw that there was no warp gate for a bit. So this is a clear indicator that indeed it's going to be a Stargate. Now, we'll see if... wait, what the hell? There's no third base yet. Okay, yeah, here it comes. Feels like a relatively late third base, honestly. Not 35 supply. I've not seen that before. I think this might have to do with the hatch block. But I didn't know this was a build order. So I think a probe just died. Yeah, one worker did die. These links are waiting for a move out with the adept. Not gonna happen, of course. And now Creator not even getting a third unit from this is going to open with a Void Ray instead. And Creator has been playing this a lot, that big Void Ray style. We see Overlord Speed coming out of Ragnarok. I don't really mind that, but it's really expensive to get Overlord Speed from if you're getting hatch blocked as a Zerg. It means you need to get a lot of gas very quickly and your minerals are a little lower already as well. I'm not a massive fan of that. It's difficult to afford for Zerg usually. See, only on three queens as well so far. It's going to get a fourth queen now. and most likely we'll actually have to get a fifth and a sixth queen too. Now there is a Stargate here. Pumping out Void Rays like his life depends on it. Two assimilators on the way for Creator as well. That's two assimilators extra before the Nexus. This is going to delay his third base, but it's going to allow for him to afford to build units from that second Stargate. And also just to build the second Stargate. With all that extra gas, you're just lacking a bit of gas. You see, 50 gas already mined, and even now he needed to have a small Void Ray cut just simply because he didn't have the gas ready. Of course, 150 gas for those Void Rays, 200 minerals in a recent patch. They got changed from 250 to 200. Also, a slight speed increase, so Void Rays are a lot quicker now, more difficult to catch, and that's why we're seeing a lot of Void Ray stuff in play. Now, a couple of timings we need to be aware of here as a Protoss player is A, Nidus's can hit around 530, 545, 550 perhaps. Queen Road stuff. Now, it's not going to be the case. There's no layer on the way yet for Ragnarok. Of course, with Overlord Speed, all of these all-ins become a lot weaker. He is, however, going to do a Queen Wall. No. Oh, he's getting it. It's a safety road wire. Very odd. This lose two. He lost three Overlords while having Overlord Speed. This is extremely expensive for Ragnarok. It's a really, really bad start. You're supposed to lose one with Overlord Speed, maybe. And not three, that's for sure. You don't even lose three if you don't get Overlord Speed. You lose one or two max, depending on where your Overlords are positioned. Five Overlords at the same time? He's gonna build Roaches. Or he's a clown. Nah, this has... Nah, drones. Also, his creep rate is very mediocre. This is a poor game by Ragnarok here. Okay, so the reason I say this is going to be roaches is because usually if Zerg wants to build the roaches, they first build a lot of overlords. Roaches are very supply heavy for how cheap they are, so you easily get supply blocked very quickly. That's why we very often see big overlord swells before a roach. Look at the supply. Creators up in supply while building void rays. This is very, very rare. Like, this is not supposed to happen. It's gonna get two queens as well, I think. No, just one. There's still a transfuser. Creator Salvage. Okay, there's one transfuse. No need to waste too much of my whole damage on this. Fleet Beacon goes down. I actually wonder what the creator is gonna play from here. Yes, triple. This was triple now, right? Yeah, triple Stargate. I feel like you can hardly afford that. I already have a rough time avoiding two. These casters are relatively late. 6:30-ish finishing up. Of course, this third was a bit delayed because of that second Stargate and four gas. Now, if we take a look at what Ragnarok is doing, he's on 70 workers. He has no units getting infestation. Yeah, this is the call. So a lot of the time these days, we see Zerg players, they want to do a push, like maybe a plus one push with like 6-7 queens, a bunch of Hydras, maybe add a couple of Banelings for the added damage against ground, like if there's some Zealots or even if there's some cannons. But if your early game is this bad, you really can't go into a push. I mean, you're just gonna lose. It's just a fact, right? Ooh, this is good. Hydras are gonna get taken out as well by these still overcharged Void Rays. Plus one not done yet. A couple of drones are gonna die. One more Hydra falls. He can fight this. This is still... Hello? Why isn't he fighting that? That was... Wait, am I the idiot? There was three Hydras against five Void Rays. You definitely win that. He could have turned around, I feel like, but he did not. But yeah, he definitely needs to go into a later game and try to kind of catch up in that way. So the thing in StarCraft is, if you get ahead in the early or mid game, that's kind of a big deal. You know, if you're up 20 supply and both of you have 100 supply, that's like 20%. And probably because you also have a lot of workers, it's more like 40 or maybe even 50% of army supply that the other guy's up. But then if you get to a maxed army, all of a sudden that 20 supply is like maybe 15%. So the advantage kind of becomes smaller in that way and easier to work around. So the longer the game goes, the better it will be for Ragnarok's relative position in this game. Which is why he probably isn't going to go for a timing, but instead we see him just gearing up for that longer late game. I would have loved to see a second Evo here, by the way, just to get those Carapace upgrades going as well. Slowly pushing out his creep threat. I say slowly once again. I emphasize his lack of creep threat, really. 8 minutes in game with, honestly, a relatively passive creator. He moved on the map with some Void Rays, but that really just is it. And I don't think this is good enough. at high level, the creep threat that we're seeing here. Now, creator on the other end is getting into disruptors. Oh god. Fleet beacon. So we have Flux Vein Void Rays, disruptors, charge. This is a pick and mix. What the hell? He's getting everything. Putting everything in his bag here. Little bit of it, little bit of that. God, what's his gate count even? He has four gateways, he's adding two more. He has no upgrades for the charge lot. So I think the charge lots are just for harassment and for cleanup duty, you know? Sometimes after you win a fight, it can be nice to have like eight zealots charge behind some Hydras. Once the Vipers are out though, this army is going to be impossible control for the TOS. As Disruptor Void Ray Templar is an army that is not easy to control at all, especially if you compare it with the Lurker Hydra Viper army. I mean, Lurkers are going to be static, so all the control is just going to come from the Zerg with the Viper Hydra, which just works together really well. Disruptor Templar, because they're so slow, it can be really difficult to control. Disruptor needs to be static while it's casting a spell as well, so yeah, I'm a little bit worried. This army feels very, very flimsy. Even though there's a lot of Void Rays here, it doesn't have a lot of a body in it. So even stuff like, even though it sounds stupid here, Lynx could be very good against this army because there's nothing really with that big splash, that big body blocking the Lynx from actually attacking the Templars or the Disruptors. So creator needs to be very, very quick here in his responses to the army movement of Ragnarok. Ragnarok, like I said, now is in a pretty comfortable position. 89 workers, Spores even pushing forward, and He's playing this very systematically, very rigorously, where he just pushes forward, spreads a bit of creep, pushes forward further. And he's actually, I think he's going to be able to push quite far. There's no Tempest out yet. Is there? No, not a single Tempest. Oh, we see a couple of Disruptors getting hit big by these Lurkers, but 2-3 Spores is going to fall immediately. Didn't use Prismatic Alignment for that. It's going to lose one more Void right here. A little bit painful. Sella charges in straight into his death. Disruptor shots are never going to hit these Hydras. 3 Tempest, I think this is the correct call 100% of the time. I mean, in order to open up these Spore positions, you just need Tempest. There's no other way around it. Carriers do not do the job. What's the air upgrade? It's room 1. And he's getting an armor upgrade? Rather than more attack. I guess against Hydras. Ooh, good Disruptor hits there. Against Hydras, it makes a little bit of sense. Nice thing about Disruptors, you can also attack Spores with. You see how hurried Ragnarok is here. He's like, I actually really want to fight right now. Good Storm gets hit. There's too many cannons here. I don't think he can move forward. Not with the Storms here, not with the Disruptors here. Of course, there's a couple of Vipers, Blinding Cloud not being used, Parasitic Bomb, yes, one hit. Still 3 Vipers with energy, good Spacer coming out of Creator. Tempest joining the fray now as well, and we see Disruptor shots, 2 get picked off. 1 lands though, and gets a big chunk of Hydras as well as does a bunch of damage. Look at this, quick expanding towards the left side by Creator during all of this. So, this is actually brilliant. He knows that he's going to lose this base eventually to the Lurkers, but he can still pick off a lot of units during the process. And he's like, I'm just going to expand to the left side, and I can always re-expand here if I want to. And I'm only going to fight if I get the best fight possible. This Parasitic Bomb is doing a lot of damage. A lot of the Void Rays are going down, but so did the Lurkers. And overall, yeah, this was a pretty decent fight here for Creator, who even manages to keep his base alive. Now, I would like if he cancelled this base, because I think it's spreading him too thin at this point. I think you don't need to get it this fast anyway. I mean, 74 workers, it's not like he can get a way bigger ego than he currently has. If he just cancels this, it's not a liability for now. It's just a position, you know? You can always take it later. He's actually pushing forward very rapidly. I'm not a fan of this. There's no Templar support. There's not a lot of constant DPS in this army. A lot of it depending on damage over time. I'm talking about Tempest, Disruptor. Oh, as the Void Rays, Tempest are about to fall against these Hydras. I feel like, yeah, big retreat here coming out of Creator. Bailing Nest as well as +1 melee on the way here. And these upgrades for these Hydras are very powerful. Of course, +3, like I said. In this type of scenario, if you have Carapace upgrades as well as the Zerg player, like 3-2, 3-3, like, we're looking at a very, very different fight here. I think Ragnarok will just completely crush it. I'm still not entirely sure about this forward position. I much prefer if he just goes back, set up his cannon defenses, gets a couple of Templar, and then he goes again. There's no need to rush for him. He's in a better position currently. He has an army that is scaling way better into the late game. I mean, basically all the expensive units that Ragnarok once had, minus the Vipers, have died. Like, there's still 3 Vipers alive. Maybe he rebuilt it. He rebuilt them. There was 5 Vipers that died. He had 5 Vipers initially. Wow. Here's the Tempest. Observer, of course, on the high ground, spotting everything. Yeah, this base is... he can't keep it. He shouldn't even care about this. This is dead. Like I said, he should have just cancelled that. Would have been the better play. He's pushing on the right side, so this base is safe. Because his army is in such close proximity, good Storms are coming out of Creator. I think Creator's in a very good spot still. A really, really nice position here. Just needs to be careful of those Vipers. Vipers, the only thing that can ruin his day. Creep spread was already very weak, is getting even weaker as Creator walks on it, takes out a couple of Tumors. Now, as he moves too far to the left side, immediately Ragnarok launches a counterattack. Not only does he try to do a little bit of damage, but he also creates a lot of space for himself for a great position here. And because this army of Creator is so focused on doing damage over time, this type of move, where Ragnarok gets a position, they can become really difficult to break for Creator, because he needs to poke and prod with Disruptors, with Tempest, shots can be dodged, Micro can be done. A couple of Void Rays and a Tempest are gonna start the mission of a lifetime. Actually, these Vipers might die. Two Vipers do die, 1 Parasitic Bomb gets cast as well though. There's still a Disruptor which can shoot, and they already did shoot. Prism is warping in. This is a poor fight here for Creator. Now lurkers are joining the fray as well. What's here still in the terms of air army? Not a lot. 4 void rays get recalled. 2 tempest don't. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. This was a very, very poor fight. Once again, he gave up this base, and then he tried to go for like a semi-base trade, but still got caught. I don't understand why his Templar count is so little, and why this Oracle only shows up now. I mean, the only thing you can really lose to against Lurker Hydra is if he outpositions you aggressively, and that shouldn't really be possible if you're playing Void Raid Tempest. I'm also confused why we don't have a Templar here and more cannons. Couple of sloppy mistakes here. Now, I think once these lurkers finish, that the Ragnarok can just move forward. Like I said, there's no real damage output in this army. There's no big oomph immortal count. There's no carriers. There's not even a mothership. I mean, the moment these lurkers burrow at a position, that position is secure for the next 3 minutes, it feels like, because 2 tempests are going to take like 5 years shooting that down. Is there even a tempest? There's no tempest right now. Yeah, you just can't fight. So it's going to go for a base trade, but he'll be able to take out this base, I guess. There's plenty of bases to go around here for Ragnarok, who now returns. There's no recall available, by the way. Templar. We're trying to set up a semi-flank. Oh my god, Void Ray is completely left unattended. Ay, ay, ay. Big storms do hit, but the army flies so little. Bad lurker burrow here. Absolutely not contributing to the fight. Yes, needs to move forward. Here we go. Lurkers first, lurkers first. Push back with your Hydras. Perfect engagement here coming out of Ragnarok. Is there a storm? There's no storm. And now this is a chase creator. Taps out as Ragnarok wins this game. Now, if you did enjoy this video, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And don't forget to leave a like as well. Thanks so much for watching and see you all next time. Bye-bye.